when he has been proven, he will receive the crown of life that he promised to those who love him. No one experiencing temptation should say, I am being tempted by God. For God is not subject to temptation to evil, and he himself tempts no one. Rather, each person is tempted when lured and enticed by his desire. Then desire conceives and brings forth sin, and when sin reaches maturity, it gives birth to death. Do not be deceived, my beloved brothers and sisters. All good giving and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no alteration or shadow caused by change. He willed to give us birth by the word of truth, that we may be a kind of first fruits of his creatures. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed the man you instruct, O Lord.
Blessed the man you instruct, O Lord.
Blessed the man whom you instruct, O Lord, whom by your law you teach, giving him rest from evil days.
Blessed the man you instruct, O Lord.
For the Lord will not cast off his people, nor abandon his inheritance. But judgment shall again be with justice, and all the upright of heart shall follow it.
Blessed the man you instruct, O Lord.
When I say, my foot is slipping, your mercy, O Lord, sustains me. When cares abound within me, your comfort gladdens my soul.
Blessed the man you instruct, O Lord. Alleluia! Try to grasp it, and we dig deeper into it so its meaning can penetrate every fiber of our own life. The 12 apostles, the 12 tribes of Israel. When we look at biblical numerology, we come to a deeper understanding of its importance. And that's why Jesus brings this to the attention of the apostles. How often do you and I hear sacred scripture every day and are asked to dive into its mystery, to place ourselves into the scene, to understand the surrounding, where Jesus was, what Jesus is speaking about, and how it applies to not persons in the text necessarily, but to each of us. Our imagination has to go right there. Not only our imagination, but in a certain sense, our body, mind, and spirit, because it affects us. God's not bound by time, nor is he bound by place or location. That's why when he says then, he's saying now. The miracles that happened to that person is the miracle that is happening to us now, to dive into its mystery and its meaning. The disciples had forgotten to bring bread, and they had only one loaf with them in the boat. In other words, God satisfies the longings of our heart. He satisfies our every need. He multiplies it to make it what he has called us to be, a leaven for the world. Be against the leaven of the Pharisees, though, and the leaven of Herod. Don't be filled with the things of this world, but be filled with God. That's why we need time to set aside to reflect and pray. We can't just rush in and rush out, check a box to say that we did something. That's why Jesus is very poignant in allowing us to dive into its meaning and mystery. Do you not yet understand or comprehend? Are your hearts hardened? Sometimes I have to reread things two or three times, because I just won't want to read my prayers. I need to pray my prayers. I don't want to just check a box, but I want its meaning to transform me. I want to be aware. I want to know and comprehend what Jesus is speaking about to me. As we celebrate the Eucharist, we rely on no longer bread, but what that bread has been changed into, the very body and blood of Christ, and how it mingles with our very body and blood. It mingles with our soul and our humanity, so that our humanity may be mingled with his divinity, and that we may become what we receive, the body of Christ in the world. Do you not yet understand or comprehend? After reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For church leaders, may the Holy Spirit continue to guide and inspire them and keep them faithful to Christ and his gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For elected officials, may they work tirelessly to uphold the dignity and sanctity of all human life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who face each day with chronic pain, may Christ the physician bring them healing and hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may God unite us ever more closely to one another and and strengthen our desire to follow him. Let us pray to the Lord.
Glory to our prayer.
For those who have died, may their hearts find rest in the perfect light of heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Glory to our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Suzanne DeSantis, Michael Stokes, Robin Smith, Ralph Speakman, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Glory to our prayer.
And for Stanley J. Lisesky, Jr., for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Glory to our prayer.
We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially for members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pretty gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they are in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed
are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy churches.
May this oblation, O Lord, we pray, cleanse and renew us, and may it become for those who do your will the source of eternal reward. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for your holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered together again into one by this Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the sacred command and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
They ate and had their fill, and what they craved the Lord gave them. They were not disappointed in what they craved.
body